Hi everybody, it's Paul from Groovy Sigs in Woolston. Just going to do a quick video about the Aspire PocX, just to try and cover some of the queries that come up. First of all, there it is. You're probably all recognising this in the shop. We sell more of these, I would say, than all other starter kits put together, because they're very reliable, they're really simple to use, and they give a great vape. So yeah, there it is. So first thing, you have a button here. You press that five times quickly to turn it on and five times quickly again to turn it off. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, he said. There we are, and that's now on, and then five quick clicks and that's now off. So that's the on off button. Has a charging port down the bottom there. It's a standard USB mini charger, so that's all pretty straightforward. And just really wanted to point out what I see as the main advantage of this kit. Which is this little hole right at the top. It's just kind of a little slit in the lid. That's where the device breathes through. That's where you take your air from. And that is above the juice. And the advantage of that, it means that it can't leak. Most of these vape kits, the breathing holes are kind of below the liquid, so there's always that risk that it might leak, particularly if you've got the wrong coil in, or you're not using it very much and burning the juice off the coil. Sometimes they can leak. The PocX never does. So to fill it up, you just take the top out like that. The coil comes out with the lid. Usually it doesn't have to, but it usually does. And you just put your juice in here. You literally just put your juice right in there, and you fill it up to just below halfway. There is a little line on there that just tells you where to fill it up to, but after a very short time you just get used to it. It's just under halfway. As far as the coil is concerned, you just unscrew it from the lid like that. And you just need to bear in mind that Aspire somewhat unhelpfully have made it such that the coil fits into the lid the wrong way as well as the right way. So all you have to remember when you're putting the coil in is this hooky bit at the top that goes in the lid. If you put it in the wrong way, it's not the end of the world. Nothing's going to blow up or anything. It just won't work. So that's something to bear in mind. New vapers may not know, but what you have to do every time you have a new vape or you put in a new coil, you have to prime the coil. Now, all that means is that you have to get the cotton wool, you just see it in there, you have to get the cotton wool wet. If it's not soaking wet with juice, then you're sucking on dry burning cotton, and that's extremely unpleasant. You know, everybody's done it, but it's not good. And if you do that, you will have fried the coil and you may have burnt the juice as well. So you'll have to just chuck the coil in the bin most of the time. Sometimes you might be able to get away with not chucking it away, but most of the time you're going to have to chuck the coil and chuck the juice and start again. So priming the coil simply means fill this up with juice or halfway, stick that on there, screw it up, and then just put it to one side, you know, for maybe quarter of an hour, something like that. You can also do it by dripping juice onto the cotton wool before you put it in. It really doesn't make any difference, because at the end of the day, it's just about the juice and the cotton wool coming into contact with each other. It really doesn't matter how you do that. One thing you can do if you want to speed up the process rather than waiting quarter of an hour is when you fill it up and you put your top in, You can just suck on the mouthpiece without pressing the button, and that way you're sucking all the juice up onto the wick, and it just speeds up the priming process. So you will, you know, take between 10 and 20, I would think, what we'd call dry drags or dry vapes off it, just sucking on it without pressing the button. And after 10 or 20 times of doing that, you'll begin to get a sense of the flavour coming through, and that's when you know that your coil is wet. So that's it. That's the Aspire Pockex. There's nothing else significant to know about it. But of course, if you do have any problems, just pop in the shop and I'm sure we'll be able to help you out. Thanks for watching. Bye.